This new front door and the entryway is probably the crown jewel of this whole project, and I think it's something our fans will really, really enjoy. One thing I'll point out is we've got this beautiful terrazzo floor throughout the whole assembly hall. Originally, there was a thought that we would just do it in the new south lobby, but we wanted to have the feeling that all of assembly hall was being renovated. So we've run it through both the east and west hallways, and it's in the north lobby as well. One of my big concerns was, because the south lobby is such a prominent feature of the new Simon Scott Assembly Hall, I didn't want this to be like a diamond on a cigar band, you know, that everything was down there and wasn't carried on through. But I think you guys can make your own judgments, but I think we have upgraded every part of Assembly Hall, so everybody will feel like their area, if you will, has been improved. So we're coming up on the Mark Cuban Center for Sports Media and Technology. We're really excited about this in a number of ways. We wanted to have the glass window so we'd have kind of the Today Show feel of the window on the world. People will come by and see it being a working, active office. This main table that's still being outfitted with the technology will really be kind of a hotel place for our students who are increasingly helping us with our video and social media operations. Most of those kids are in the media school. We feel like this is a great integration opportunity. As you know, one of our goals is to be integrated with the university, so it's been a great collaboration with the media school, where we get some real cutting edge expertise and they get some real world experience. We've got the soundproof booth for recording, and then what we're really excited about is our virtual reality studio, the ORAD studio, which I think is the only one that'll be in a intercollegiate department of athletics, and probably one of the only ones in a sports organization of any kind. There may be less than a handful that are in major professional sports level. So we'll go in and you can take a look around, but that's the overview. So it's just like a giant green screen, and this is where bar graphs will come up out of the ground and tornadoes will swirl around, and all kind of the sky's the limit in terms of the special effects that we can do. And we'll do we can do coaches shows in there, we can do highlight intros, and we're really excited about that space. As you guys know, Mark Cuban gave us a $5 million gift to establish this center. Probably less than a third of that was in the build out of this. Most of it we've invested in the technology, the ORAD virtual reality, but also the 3D replay and the virtual reality technology we've been using. There we go. We're coming into probably the most dramatic and exciting part, the south lobby and atrium. So there's a lot to absorb here. One thing I want to point out early on is the wayfinding signs. Those are all new, but we tried to make them really replicas of the original wayfinding sign, and I think it really helps keep that feel of Assembly Hall. It feels like your Assembly Hall, the drive carefully and all that. That's throughout. We maintain the wayfinding signage. These are touch screens that you can, does this work? I should probably have pre-figured this out.
Yes.
Yeah, so we can look at, you know, we want to look at our All-Americans, for example, and then you kind of go through here and you can, I think, do all this and say, oh, I want to look at Branch McCracken. And, you know, he's got all of his stats and pictures from the archives. You can thumb through those. This is ridiculous, and our IT staff, the IU Athletics Information Technology staff, programmed this whole thing. And I think our fans are going to love this, because I think every game will be a new opportunity to dig in and look at different pieces. And because we are the state university, we include a lot of information about Indiana High School All-Stars. You can go back and look at your school and find out, you know, how many Indiana Mr. Basketballs went to IU and so forth and so on. So we've got several of these, and I think this is going to be one of those gifts that keep on giving for our fans. I think they'll really enjoy that. Other technology includes, we'll be out here, these large LED screens. They're 135 square feet. One of the things we thought of, well, if we put pictures up, who's going to be on the banner? Like, who's on Lucas Oil Stadium, you know, that has the permanent banner? We thought, well, wouldn't it be awesome if we could rotate through? So sometimes those will be standing pictures of players or events. Sometimes it'll be famous games, video, information, messaging, and we can also live stream the game out here during the game. And those things are really big, so I think that will have a great impression. You just get a feel of the size of this new front door, which I love. That's part of what we were trying to get, a new front door facing campus to really be where you arrive at Simon Scott Assembly Hall. Obviously the ramps are gone. In their place are these wide stairwells and escalators. There'll be escalators on the south side as well. Interestingly, interesting to me anyway, escalators were originally a part of the engineering and design for Assembly Hall, but it got value engineered out. They didn't put them in because they were trying to save money. But that was a great help to us because the bases were in place and it made it easier and less expensive for us to add them. And I think our fans will really like that as well. Another big feature is the window on the basketball court. We've got the shades, you know, can go up and down, but we can cheat a little bit here. During the game, fans will be able to look in on the court. A lot of times people come here and say, we just want to go down and see the court. And we can't really do that, but now we'll be able to. Generally, people will be able to come and look and see the court. And people come from all around the state and all around the country during the week and ask to see the court. And we haven't been able to accommodate that, but we will going forward. I guess that's something that's appropriate to mention. Starting Monday from 9 to 5, this south lobby will be staffed. So average Hoosier fans can come in unannounced, no appointment necessary, between 9 and 5 and get a tour of the south lobby and the two hallways, including the Cuban Center. If the shades are up, they can look at the Assembly Hall court. It's really important for us to create this in a way that facilitated Indiana fans enjoying it, and I think that'll be a big plus. There you go. Since we're raising this up, maybe I'll talk a little bit about the actual arena part. So all the chairs are all the non-bleacher seats are new. They're all in the cream and crimson look. Some of you may recall that on the edges there were blue seats. Those are gone. They've all been replaced by the red and white. They all have it's very subtle, but there's an IU logo on each one of the seats. The seat is a non-porous, comfortable, extra padded surface. And I don't know about you guys, but I always wondered what might have seeped into that porous seat over the last 45 years. It's kind of not really pleasant to think about. But and those seats hadn't been replaced in 45 years. Individual seats have sometimes been replaced when they were broken or so broken that we had to fix them. But those are all brand new. Something we think the fans will enjoy. A big part of this is the gigantic new Jumbotron. It's bigger, clearer, and tighter than the old scoreboard. You may or may not recall the old scoreboard had two panels on each of the four sides with a little ring around the rosy thing in the middle that, candidly, I found sort of distracting. What we want to do is have a single panel facing each of the four corners of the arena, if you will. And this board has about 1,500 square feet of flat surface. The old board had about 1,000 square feet of old surface. So I didn't go to Purdue, but even I can figure out that that's 50% bigger scoreboard. And there's over 3 million pixels in that, which I have no idea what that means. Other than it's like super clear, super definition, super high def, so it'll be like watching the best TV that you can buy in your living room. We also think that's really going to improve the fan experience throughout the arena, but particularly up in the balconies.
Inspiration from the designer, or did you say that?
No.
Okay.
Yeah. You may also notice that a lot of the metal railings have been replaced with acrylic. So that improves the sights, the line of vision for our fans, and also is just generally safer. We didn't keep it in the front row because it seemed unnecessary, but up, especially in front of the vomitories, you can see that it's all acrylic. Jeremy was prompting me about all this artsy stuff, about how the scoreboard's reminiscent of all these arches and curves and all this really groovy stuff. I don't really know much about that, so we'll leave that in the press release, and you can read about that later. But it does fit in, and I think the lettering on it is very cool. The last year, you may or may not have noticed, we moved the championship banners to the north end, partly in preparation for this, and also because they would be blocking the view of the new Spirit of 76 club, but also it's cool that people can see them when they come in here to look at them. So that's the main purpose of that. I'll go ahead and mention now that some of you would watch the game, I think, down here in the press area. We have a new press area, and while it's up high, it's a lot roomier. It's all wired. You can plug your stuff in. We'll have food and beverage up there, and we think it'll frankly be more comfortable for the media. It also enables us to free up 98 seats that we'll put in the student section. So 98 more students will be able to sit in the south end zone, which is their favorite place to sit anyway. So that'll be a plus. I'll go ahead and mention now improved accessibility all throughout the stadium. This will be all seating for persons with disabilities. The concession stands are made to be particularly accessible, including for people with disabilities in terms of the counter height. All the new bathrooms are made accessible for people with disabilities and 100% compliant with the Americans with Disability Act. So, you know, the purpose of this whole project, is probably worth saying, was to preserve the best home court advantage in college basketball. That was my main goal. It wasn't really to dramatically change the arena, and as you guys can see, or you can make your own judgments, I don't think we've done that. I think we've improved the seats. I think the look of the seats is better. The feel will be better. The Jumbotron will make it a greater fan experience. We will have the premium seating, but otherwise, the court itself remains fairly unchanged. I love the Indiana. We always wanted to do something up there. We talked about doing players or whatever, but I think this is what Indiana basketball is about. It is about Indiana. And not only Indiana University, but again, as the flagship state university, we think it's great to embrace Indiana basketball in all of its forms, IU basketball, high school basketball, and so forth. And that, as you may have seen, it really looks cool at night, you know. This is, the lighting, I think, here is really cool, and it gives a good feel even when you're outside of the arena. The other thing, this may be a good one to mention, that is the old scoreboard that hung in Assembly Hall from its inception in 71 to, I think, 2001. Jeremy, is that right? I may not be exactly right on that, but I think it's about right.
2001's when that center hung came down.
Okay. Yeah, so it was there for whatever that is, 30 years. We cut that in two and put it on each side of the top of the stairwell. And the really cool thing is that thing's going to be lit up live. So it'll carry the score and the time in real time during the game. And I think that's one of the fun things that we've incorporated into the overall design of the building. As you can see, they're filling out the trophy cases here. We wanted to try to keep that Indiana field house, Indiana high school gym feel with trophy cases and trophies. So it's not all whiz-bang touchscreen technology, which is awesome, but it's also the feel of a high school gym, high school trophy case. A lot of this work was done by our in-house tradesmen. So we're going to see a really cool basketball court that those guys cut, the carpenters. The scoreboard, I believe, was refurbished in-house. So it's been real. One of the really neat things about this has been the average worker. Many of whom have come up to me and said, you know, this has been a thrill of a lifetime to work on this building. I grew up in Bloomington. I went to IU or not, but this has been a real thrill. And I've been really heartened by a couple guys that said, you know, man, I didn't really like the idea of somebody renovating Assembly Hall, but this feels like home. They've been very positive. And those are just, you know, guys from Bloomington who I think reflect maybe what will hopefully be the overall feel of Hoosier Nation. So we have 128 new fixtures, which is a 68% increase over what we had before. And in addition to all the new bathrooms and new fixtures, all the old fixtures and all the old bathrooms have been renovated and upgraded. I always wondered why there was blue tile in some of the bathrooms. There's no more blue tile. It's all red. The partitions have been replaced. The fixtures have been scrubbed. And so all of our fans will have much better facilities to utilize. We also have 16 all-gender bathrooms, which is 16 more than we had before. So we're very pleased to have those for individuals as well as families to use as they deem appropriate. We're going to walk into the Hanke Spirit of 76 Club. It's our new premium hospitality seating. We really had no premium hospitality seating. Assembly Hall was built before suites and all that were the rage. We'll have about 83 seats in the Hanke Spirit of 76 Club, and I think you'll see that it's going to be a pretty special opportunity for some of our fans that want that amenity. So, you know, honoring the Spirit of 76, the idea here is we're honoring the 76 team, which I argue is the greatest team in the history of college basketball, but we're calling it the Spirit because the spirit of that team is what we think makes Indiana basketball generally what it is. So some cool pictures, including particularly the one of the guys walk on the streets in New York, which is one of my all-time favorite pictures, and not surprisingly, made its way into the middle of that collage. I think it's hard for our fans to think how close you're going to be. I thought the feel would be that you're further away, but when you look, because where the baseline is, you get a good view of the whole court, and I don't think it feels too high. And you've got the Jumbotron that looks like almost a TV in your living room, plus the monitors. I think this will be something that our fans who can afford that and want that will be able to really enjoy. The most dramatic one is, you probably can't really see it, but there's acrylic as the guard in at the end of the balcony, which used to be a pipe. And again, I'm very thankful that nobody slipped through that pipe or fell down or a little kid or something like that. That's gonna be much safer having the acrylic up there. How you doing? Good. Thanks for the good work, man. Things look great. How you doing? So it's the balance of our national championships and the other interlocking IU. And this is all new here. That was a safety piece. Again, thank God nobody, especially students who go up and down here, goofing around and fell through here. So this will be all much safer with the additional bars and so forth. I'll also mention with these pictures, we'll have over 100 when we're done. We'll have over 150 frame pictures throughout Assembly Hall in the main areas, also the stairwells. That includes the composites, like for the national championships and the Big Ten championships and all that. But I think our fans will have fun looking at those. We spent a lot of time picking cool pictures out of our archives. We'll have 66 monitors at the concession stands. 2, 4, 6. Yep, 11 concession stands, 6 at each one. So we'll be able to put our menu up there. We'll run in-game video, so when people come, they're able to not miss much of the action. And I think the whole food experience is going to be better. We're going to have more selection. I think better food, more points of sale, so the lines will go more quickly. The monitors will help the experience. And one of the ways, this is a little inside baseball, but this concession stand used to only come out to this bar here. And that, believe it or not, that little amount of space really impeded us having the number of workers that we needed back there. So by knocking this out, you know, 3 or 4 feet, and then lowering it for accessibility reasons, we think we're really going to improve the concession stand experience. So this is, I think, will be a big plus. Can you guys can just see the acrylic stuff there? Again, I think it's a big plus for both safety and fans being able to enjoy the game. And there's a lot of it, a lot more of it than I ever thought, and it's not cheap, but it was the right thing to do. I'll tell a little personal story. Originally, we were just going to have escalators in the south lobby. And I was talking to my wife about what we were doing, and she goes, "You're not putting escalators in the north lobby?" I'm like, no. And she goes, "How many kinds of stupid are you? I mean, this is where the old people come from. The students don't need the escalators that much. They're coming in the south. But the older donors, they need it more." So thanks to some initiative from Barbara Glass, we looked aggressively at the escalators, and that's when we found out that they were built for them. There was this gap here, and the base was built in. So we added these. I'm really, really glad we did, because again, on the diamond on a cigar band metaphor, we really wanted the north lobby not to be an afterthought. This was the assembly hall court from just after the 1976 season through what, Jeremy? 1995. And I knew that we had this in storage, and just thought putting this out here again, I think, will be a fabulous Kodak moment for our fans. One thing I'm really proud of is the carpenters, the trade carpenters at IU, put that whole thing together, and I wanted the feel of the kind of the jagged edges. They cut all that out, did all the trim. Somebody, not me, had the idea to backlight it, which I think really makes it cool. So again, with the scoreboard in the south lobby, there's some really old pieces that we've incorporated into the building. A sneak preview, it won't be ready for a while yet, but some of you guys that have been around longer will remember the old stanchions on the basketball goals. They went away like in around 2000, I think, but they were here from when the building opened, and they looked really weird, kind of. They had a big arch to them and all kinds of metal on it. But if you didn't know anything else about the game, if you saw those stanchions, you knew it was Bloomington and Assembly Hall, because nobody else had them. They were made here. We rescued those from being stored out at the golf course, believe it or not, and our in-house tradesmen, again, are cleaning those up. And one will hang on each end of this overhang by the court. And so I'm hopeful here in the next, maybe before the first official game, I don't know for sure, we'll have that. And I think especially our longtime fans will get a kick out of that being incorporated into the design. We weren't quite sure what to do with this. Every one of our other Final Four teams had been Big Ten champions. And so their composites are set forth in our Big Ten champion hallway. 92 did not win the Big Ten championship, but were in the Final Four, and so we wanted to have them highlighted as well, and here they are. You recall that all the Hall of Fame pictures were up here, which, with all due respect, looked like they were hung. Actually, I won't say that. They weren't hung great, and they were kind of all over the place. So we've digitized all of those, and those are accessible on the touch screen, which we think will be neat for families and all that to go through those and be able to see those. The hard copies are in one of those old karma poster frame things. in the Hanke Hall of Champions. So they can still see the original portraits, but I think they'll be more accessible electronically with the touch screens. So the guys are still working on building out the cabinets. These are going to hold our Big Ten champion trophies and other trophies. Again, trying to mix the old with the new. We've got touch screens, the technology, but we've also got trophy cases with our trophies in them. Who recognizes this guy? Don Fisher, baby. So I don't know how many of you guys were ever down here before, but this was like a hot mess down here. But I think this really shows how much technology is driven by the Cuban Center. Hey guys. Jeremy, this is your bailiwick. Do you want to talk a little bit about what goes on here?
Yeah, so this actually just used to be where the video staff had their offices, and then they would roll in and roll out on game days, and it was a very tight configuration. This has now been gutted, cleaned out. They have this as a permanent location. Then we have a giant server room where you know about all of the 3D technology that was installed in basketball last year. The server room is here. It's climate controlled. They're going to be able to do all sorts of things with video board shows, managing the control rooms, 3D data storage, file storage. It's pretty impressive. And then there's going to be a second control room that's going to go in here.
Jeremy, just real quick. So yes. You saw the ORAD virtual reality studio, the giant green room upstairs. Yes. Literally, the old studio was that corner of this room with a blanket taped up for the backdrop. Yeah. So that's a, I'd say, significant improvement.
Significant upgrade.
All right, go ahead. So we've got permanent seating. You can spread out a little bit. They're all wired up. These are new counters here. Again, all wired up. We'll have some pictures and other things to make it feel homey. Originally, that Indiana, I will tell you, Script Indiana was black. I'm not into black Script Indiana, so I had them change it to red. But I've been in a lot of press rooms. You guys have been in more than I have, but I think this will really put us in a good place, whereas before we just weren't. Our goal was to try to keep this a lot like it was. I just think it's better than, though, our fans will make their own judgments, but I think the Jumbotron will be a really big plus. The seats will be a big plus. I think they were just gross, and springs were poking up into people and stuff. And then the acrylic guardrails, again, we really started looking at it from a visibility perspective. Our fans be able to see the game better, but what became clear soon was we really need to do it for safety reasons, especially up there in the balcony. You know, the glass backboards were invented at Indiana University. When they moved from the men's gymnasium to the old field house, that's Wildermuth now, fans complained that they couldn't see through the wooden backboards. And so they went to a local glass store and they made the glass backboards right here, and that was the first one ever made. So always innovative. We're back to where we started, but I think Jeremy had a good idea. If you want to, we'll go back to the south lobby and go out the front, so you can have a feel just right out in front. That's Ken Nunn's Champions Plaza. Thanks to a gift from Ken Nunn, we were able to do some great things, I think, with landscaping, lighting. And again, you make your own judgments, but I love the way it's kind of like the front yard to our new front door. And it reaches out to campus and also really ties in with Cook Hall. So why don't we go out that way and kind of check that out? And then I think we're about there. But it does, you know, just feeds right into Cook Hall, makes it more of a basketball complex, I think. The lighting is not copied, but it's complementary and similar. The architects would tell you a bunch of stuff that I'm not very good at, but there's a real theme of these ribbed columns. So they really started in the old field house. With the rib columns, they're carried over into Cook Hall. They were in the original assembly hall, if you look on the sides, and they brought those out here. And really a little bit in Memorial Stadium too. Little known fact, Memorial Stadium and assembly hall were designed at the same time and meant to be complementary to each other. They got Memorial Stadium built in 60. It took them another 11 years to raise the money and build Assembly Hall, but there are some similarities. Cindy Simon really connected with Indiana basketball when her dad, Mel, would bring her to the basketball games. And he was a huge basketball fan, and she started coming when she was like 8 years old. And as we talked about her interest in Indiana and maybe making the gift, that was a big part of it. Assembly Hall meant a lot to her because there was a huge connection with her father. And later I was asked, well, when did you start cultivating the gift with Cindy? And I said, well, when she was 8 years old. You know, that's really when that gift started. And we're going to have great donor recognition in there. That's a silhouette of a dad holding his daughter's hand, you know, going to the game. And how many of us can relate to that? On some of us on both ends of that equation. I've got a granddaughter that's two. But I think that's going to be very poignant, and it reflects the story of Cindy's getting involved, interested in IU basketball. Of course, she was a student here, and all that came later. I think we'll be judged by others, and that's how it should be. But I think this is a very successful project, and part of the reason I think it's very successful is early on we set out exactly what we were wanted to do. We told the trustees what we wanted to do. We told the campus architects what we wanted to do. We told our other architects what we wanted to do. And as the course of the project went on and people would talk about value engineering or can you do without this, do without that, there were things that we could do without and we did do without, but we didn't do without anything that was on that original list. Improving the concession stands, improving the bathrooms, Jumbotron, replacing the seats, escalators, a dramatic new atrium, all that, the terrazzo floor. There was a little arm twisting over that. Hey, do you really need to put terrazzo through the whole place? Yeah, you know, that's what we said we were going to do. And it seems like a small thing, but I think small things like that become really big things, because I just don't think it would have as good a feel if we hadn't done terrazzo through the whole place. And that stuff is really expensive, you guys, but I think it was really, really worth it.